because there's too many cheetahs.
Stop that. What about this? Do you like baseball?
I love baseball.
You know, they give ball players nowadays very strange names.
Funny names?
Nicknames. Now, on the St. Louis team, we have who is on first, what is on second, I don't know who's on third.
Well, that's what I want you to tell me. I want you to tell me the names of the fellows on the St. Louis team.
I'm telling you who is on first, what is on second, I don't know who's on third.
You know the fellows' names?
Yes.
Who's on first?
Yes.
I mean, the name of the guy on first base.
Who?
The name of the fellow playing first base.
Who?
The guy playing first base.
Who is on first base?
When you pay off the pitcher, when you pay off the pitcher on the first of every month, who gets the money?
Every dollar of it. Why not? The man's entitled to it.
Who is?
Yes.
So, who gets the money?
Why shouldn't he? Sometimes his wife comes out and collects it.
Who's wife?
Yes. After all, the man earns it.
Who does?
Absolutely.
You got a pitcher on the team.
Wouldn't this be a fine team without a pitcher?
Tell me the pitcher's name.
Tomorrow.
So when the guy at bat bunts the ball, me being a great catcher, I pick it up and I throw it to who?
Now that's the first thing you said right.
I don't even know what I'm saying.
Take it easy. Calm down.
I pick up the ball and throw it to who? So the guy gets up and goes to second. Who throws it to what? What throws it to I don't know. I don't know throws it to tomorrow. A triple play.
Yeah, it could be.
Another guy gets up and it's a long ball to center.
Because?
Why? I don't know. And I don't care.
What was that?
I said I don't care.
Oh, that's our shortstop.
Love scenes.
I'll say, you must really be in love to act like you do.
For though. It was the Nightingale. Not that you would know a Nightingale when most of us in that particular pair of yours.
Well, you certainly recognize a lot. Or take it, or better words than I love to see any one of them.
And what on earth do you mean by that?
Only that being married to you is no favor. It is no luck. It is certainly no better roses.
Hey, you're Bill Grant.
Who is this?
New act!
I'm Susie, and this is Buddy, and we're huge fans!
I saw you guys in Trent in 22. Robert and Roberta LeGrand, the most romantic couple in vaudeville, performing all the romantic love scenes from Shakespeare.
I tapped on you in Trenton. You were complete.
Ah, Trenton. What a romantic city. We dined at Oysters.
Ah, yes, I remember. We watched the full moon rise from our balcony. I bought you roses.
Roses. Come, love. Let us rehearse our Shakespeare.
Nothing would make me happy.
Something like that.
That explains a lot.
and Susie.
I like that.
I told you, it should be Susie and Buddy.
I don't like that either.
Well, what then?
How about the Glasgow Sisters? Somebody get this kid a dress.
Come on, kid. We better get you up to wardrobe.
Great Zamboni. Supposed to be the Great Zamboni.
I am the Great Zamboni. A wizard, magician extraordinaire.
And the greatest escape artist who ever lived?
Yes. Well,
you've been in that straitjacket for 2 hours.
It's just that I forgot the trick.
Forgot the trick? I'm the one who's supposed to saw in half and forgot the trick. You know, I can write out enough and I can bring it to it. What's in this thing?
How should I know? I'm just Lou, the merchant's box delivery guy. My job's not to open the box. My job's just to deliver the box. Sign here.
I'll sign it.
Say, Lou, you ever get to see the show?
Yeah, I love those dancing chickens.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, all the way from deepest, darkest Albania, by way of Perth Amboy, I present to you the Shanky Siblings. And most importantly, with my ears covered. Ladies and gentlemen, that was the Shankman Sessions. And now for our next act, the lottery applaud of Heartfully to Hear Her, Mrs. Amy Olsen.
Thank you.
announcement to make.
You're getting a separate dress room for the dancing chickens?
Hey, the dancing chickens are the best part about this show.
I like to announce that...
That the great Zamboni finally escaped from a straitjacket.
Not yet.
That the world is bent on certain doom.
Are you adding another show?
Yeah, so Mrs. Light can finally get that for Coke.
Ladies and gentlemen, the contents of this box will revolutionize the Palace Theater.
Is it indoor plumbing?
Is it a new act? Because we could really use one of those.
He finally booked Gus Benson in a singing duck.
No, it's a chimpanzee ventriloquist.
Is it boxing toddlers?
Is it Jack Benny?
Yeah, you got a Jack in the Box.
Can someone deal with these hecklers?
Hecklers? My grandmother can heckle better than this.
She's been dead for 3 years.
Alright, I'll take care of it for you. Alright, folks. What's the matter? Don't make me get a batter. They'll make you flatter than a platter. So I don't have to be a smatter or patter, got it?
Thank you, Max. Ladies and gentlemen, in this box is a motion picture projector.
Motion picture projector? What do you want with the motion picture projector?
I'm gonna go out on a limb here and guess he wants to use it to project motion pictures.
But who would want to watch motion pictures when they can come see vaudeville?
Who? Who? Everyone, that's who. I tell you, motion pictures are the hottest thing going, and starting tonight, they're going in the Palace Theater.
What? Between the shows?
Not exactly. Max, tell Cora and Nora and tell them to get this thing installed.
They don't know how to install a motion picture projector.
Well, we are showing the Gold Rush at, 8 o'clock, so they've got until then to figure it out.
So, if I'm slaying hash, somebody's gotta wait tables.
You mean we can keep working together?
Of course!
She's here. She saw the car drive up outside.
Car? That's the fanciest limousine in Genoa.
Charlie Chaplin. If I didn't hate him with his movie pictures, I'd be so excited.
You look pretty excited.
Here he comes.
This is the palace, Mr. Chaplin. Would you like to make a statement for the press, Mr. Chaplin?
Get your bags right here, Mr. Chaplin.
Everything goes safe, Mr. Chaplin.
How was your trip, Mr. Chaplin?
We only have 2 hours till the New York train, Mr. Chaplin.
Mr. Chaplin. Welcome to the Palace Theater. This way to my office, Mr. Chaplin. Mr. Chaplin.
Mr. Chaplin, let him
work.
Mr. Chaplin, wait. Mr. Chaplin.
That was Charlie Chaplin.
He looks shorter in real life. He looks cuter in real life.
Who are all those people with him?
I don't know, his entourage or something.
Entourage? I don't see a word like that.
Has he ever done a Shakespeare? Has he ever moved the audience to the audience?
Let's be honest here. The only way you move an audience is towards the exit.
The Grands, you're on at 5. Can you pretend you love each other this time?
What do you mean pretend? Don't you?
Meet the greatest actors on the list.
Luck up, kid. You'll find another job. You look great in a dress.
Last night of vaudeville. This is supposed to be our first night of vaudeville.
First, the world is empty and meaningless. Now I'm in the toy.
We gotta do something, Pops. Buddy and I just got here.
Not making a vaudeville. That's what we'll do.
Easy, kid. Something else.
Mr. Bud is a right to this the calls for action.
Hey, you escaped.
Of course I escaped. I am the great Zamboni.
I cut him out with a stick.
Never underestimate the importance of an assistant.
Did I hear that we're taking action because I cannot live without vaudeville?
I don't know. I think you could do pretty well with silent pictures.
Silent pictures. No one can hear me sing.
Exactly.
Listen, I have a plan.
Zamboni.
Okay, Helena and I have a plan.
Zamboni.
Okay, Helena has a plan.
What's the plan, Helena?
Well, you know the great Zamboni's not the best magician.
Sure, it is. Houdini, Carter the Great.
That's the new kid we saw on the street this morning.
Heck, I'm as good as that kid. Almost.
There's one trick the great Zamboni knows how to do.
It's a disappearing box.
You make a box disappear?
Oh, no. I put a person in the box and make a person disappear.
Where do they go?
I can't tell you that. But tonight we use the disappearing box to rid the world of that pesky tramp and his moving pictures.
The great Zamboni is going to make Charlie Chaplin disappear.
Oh, that's a plan.
We spent a long time since I've been on a vaudeville stage.
You probably don't remember me, but we're in the same middle of Chicago in 1912.
You were the scene juggler, right?
That's right.
Those were good times.
What do you do now, Mr. Chaplin?
I'm an actor in the silent pictures.
An actor? How do you remember all those lines?
I don't have any lines. It's silent pictures, which means the picture of a cycle.
I've been to Colin
Now concentrate. Is this your card?
No.
Is this your card?
I see it. No.
The Queen of Diamonds.
No.
I'm out of cards.
Is your card the Ace of Clubs? Yeah.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Bye-bye now. And in this box, on this very night, we shall make a member of this audience disappear. What's that? We have a special assistant this evening. Would you welcome to our stage a Mr. Charlie Chaplin? A Mr. Charlie Chaplin!
Very well, very well.
What is haberdashery? I have no idea. I just like saying the word. Haberdashery.
Shankman's, you're on five.
What do you say, Shankman's? Out with a bang?
Out with a bang.
I shall find room before you.
I'm right here!
Shoe fly pie.
no shepherd's pie, no Argentinian beaver pie.
Well, we have done that.
Really?
No, not really.
We have a custard pie.
We have a custard pie.
We'll have a custard pie.
One custard pie.
One custard pie.
You are, sir? One custard pie.
Would you like some, sir?
Yes.
He asked for it.
Now sit down.
Officer, I'm telling you, don't
before. Did this Supreme Trick with trying to happen this evening?
It's not a trick, it's an illusion.
But did you make him disappear?
I did.
Where is he?
I can't tell you that.
You can tell me. I'm a police officer.
No, I really don't know where he is.
Well, can you bring him back?
Of course I can bring him back. Either I make people disappear every night and I don't bring them back, what kind of monster do I am?
Well, bring him back now.
I can't.
Well, you just said you can bring him back.
Bring him back and leave the box.
We smashed that box to smithereens, just like you asked, Officer Waldo. There was no Charlie Chaplin in there.
You smashed up the box?
At one point, I thought I saw Douglas Fairbanks, but that's just because Nora hit me on the head with her hammer.
I did not hit you on the head.
You smashed up the box.
I told you I wouldn't be sorry.
And even if I did, there was no excuse to smash a door over my head.
Your head's the hardest thing around.
You smashed up the box.
Yes, just like you asked us to.
Without that box, there's no Charlie Chaplin.
The box! And I'm going to smash up Cora and leave the door off my head.
I gotta go.
So you're telling me?
I'm telling you what I've been trying to tell you for the past 10 minutes. Without that box, there's no Charlie Chaplin.
When this gets out, I'll be lucky to work the carpool line at Genoa Schools.
Like I said, Helena built the box. She just hired me as the Great St. Wilde's type to fit the costume and do the accent.
Not really a magician, then.
I'm not even Italian.
Well, I guess I still got a pretty good story. Charlie Chaplin gone forever.
Sure, you've got a story, but I've got to go back to Hollywood to face the presses. I don't know what I'm going to say.
Are you sure there's nothing else you can tell us about the trick?
Honestly, all I do is stand in front of the people and pretend to go out of town.
Have you ever thought about becoming a publicist?
Here you are tonight, delivered straight from a biograph theater down the street. 6 years from Keystone Property.
Get those up to a projection booth, Lou. I don't care if I have to wait another week to get another copy of the Gold Rush. Tonight's the last night in Vaudeville, and I mean it.
Well, LeGrand's doing the balcony scene for the last time.
Tonight, it almost seems like they really love each other.
What's left on the bill?
Just the finale.
People already lined up outside people with pictures. Apparently we're famous. Me and my Charlie Chaplin disappeared.
Ingrid wants us to think of finale.
Oh, why not?
Why not? Maybe because she's the worst singer in the world.
Just think of her as the best in the world and singing badly.
Family, 5 minutes. Cora, Nora, I need those Keystone Comedies on the projector.
5 minutes until we all sat on the stage for the last time. It's been a real pleasure working with you, Shankmans. You two, Stanley Livingston.
The honor is ours.
What was that?
I was only crying a little bit.
Not that. That.
Oh, that's Naki, Mr. Knight.
Yes, but what if Coffee did Naki?
Well, what you do is you put your hand in the fist and you get it up.
I know that. What I want to know is who is knocking.
Sounds like whoever's in the trunk.
Yes, but who is in the trunk?
Whoever is knocking.
I know that. Will someone please open the stupid trunk?
Good thing, Mr. Knight.
Charlie Chaplin!
So that's where he went.
That was a good magic trick.
It's not a trick, it's an illusion.
Well, my congratulations on a wonderful illusion. If you'd ever like to work in Hollywood, give me a call.
I don't suppose you found the Gold Rush in there.
We've been wrong projector this whole time. We have the Gold Rush.
Oh, what a relief.
Here, Mr. Chaplin. You might want this.
Charlie! You bought me a fur coat. What a nice surprise.
But that's just an old
shh. It's a fur coat. That's all that matters.
Now, did someone say something about it now?
Yeah, we're on it too.
And Ingrid wants to sing.
Would you mind if I join you?
A bit on, Mr. Chaplin.
What about Ingrid? I usually do. Now, ladies and gentlemen, performing on the vaudeville stage for the first time since 1912, the Palace Theater would like to welcome their very own Pops McCoy and Charlie Chaplin to the stage.
Thank you.
Sitting out there in the dark, waiting to be amazed.